Okay, so some of you are having trouble getting a really even wash around the branches of your pussy willows. So we did this in class, but I thought I'll just put it on video for you. So what we're going to do is wet a couple of these triangles. So I just made a series of triangles. I'm not worried right now about my actual painting, because I'm practicing. So I only want to wet as much area as I think I can handle at one time. I want my water to be a satin sheen, which means it's shiny, but I don't want any puddles. So if I have puddles, I can squeeze out my brush and lift them so that I don't end up with water that is really out of control. So we're going to work with the indigo. I'm not sure what you can see on the camera. I'm trying to make it so that you can get a close-up view of this process. Now, I want you to watch. I'm not going to outline first. You don't want to do that because sometimes that makes a ghost line that you can't get rid of. So we're going to just drop in the color, let the water do the majority of the work. And I have the brush on its side. Do you see the amount of area I'm covering? So I can put that in without too much trouble. Okay? Now, if I want to fade it out to white, then I can take a brush with just water and pull that. Okay? So I'm going to do that. And we'll just add more water and come up in here. And we want to trust the paint to follow the water out. Okay? So if you feel that you are just struggling at first to just do the basic control, then I don't want you to worry about trying to do the graded wash. I just want you to work on trying to get an even tone. Okay, so now I'm still wet. Let's finish this up here. And I can make this area darker. All I have to do, this one, is just touch some of the indigo right in there. I'm not making a stroke, and I'm going to leave that, and I'm going to let that dry. It will dry lighter than what you see here. So keep going around your circle and trying to get this graded wash until you feel like you have control over it. If you have a lot of texture, then that becomes distracting. And you want the background to support the painting subject. You don't want it to become such a strong feature that it draws the eye. All right? So I'm going to actually pause this. I want you to take a look at what that looks like, and I'll turn it back on in a few minutes so that we capture what it looks like once it's dry. Okay?